My daily cup of Joe. Hi, this is Monique Schoenhage speaking. I'm a maternal fetal medicine physician here at Tucson Medical Center, and this is What You Want to Know. Today we're going to talk a little bit about caffeine in pregnancy. Oops! My daily cup of Joe. My favorite thing in the morning, my little pick-me-up. Sometimes I actually drink a cup of tea. There's big differences between coffee and tea. Tea has a substantially less content of caffeine. An average cup of coffee has anywhere from 100 milligrams to 200 milligrams of caffeine. This is important because the American College of Obstetrics and Gynecology recommends that we only consume less than 200 milligrams of caffeine daily. Does not say you cannot drink coffee, does not say that this amount will cause any issues for you and your baby. But it does say, and it does recommend, that you not overly indulge coffee. For example, some of the side effects that you may experience, the jitteriness, trembling, a greater sense of awareness or awakeness, that's all common with the use of coffee. But guess what? So is your baby. Therefore, a monster drink, which is a significant boost of caffeine, 5-hour energy drinks, diet pills, of course, not recommended in pregnancy, but anything with a super abundant amount of caffeine can equally affect your baby, particularly into the third trimester. As we think about monitoring the child or looking at the child on ultrasound, a significant amount of caffeine that you may have taken in immediately prior to those evaluations can affect our recommendations and how your baby appears. 200 milligrams of caffeine daily is about a cup to a cup and a half of coffee. It is 5 or 6 cups of tea, however. Some of the common misconceptions about use of caffeine in pregnancy include: it will prevent me from getting pregnant, it will cause miscarriages, and it will cause birth defects and or growth problems for my child. Again, the American College of Obstetrics and Gynecology recommends use of less than 200 milligrams of caffeine. At this level, there have been no effects either in trying to get pregnant, achieving pregnancy, maintaining your pregnancy, or growth in your child.